Hey, church family, it's so nice to see you again. Today, we have a special treat for you. Our male intern, Sam Umstead, will be bringing us our devotional thought for tonight. Sam is attending Free Hardman University. He will be a junior, and he's from Lexington, Tennessee. We are really excited to hear Sam's message and to see what great work he will do for us this summer. So at this time, we're going to give it over to Sam. But before we do, let's open up with a prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we're so thankful for this beautiful day that you have given to us. We're so thankful for all of the rain and the sun that you give to us. We're so thankful for all the many blessings and everything you do. We ask you to please continue to bless us. In Jesus' name, amen. Sam?
Hey everybody, I hope you guys have had an amazing day. I know that mine's been pretty great, and I'm very thankful for the opportunity to come work with you this summer. My name is Sam Umstead. I'm from Freed Hardman University. I am going to be a junior. I'm a Bible major with an emphasis in youth and family ministry, and I'm very excited, like I said, to be working with you this summer. But just for a moment, I want to talk to you about something that's been bothering me recently, something that I personally struggle with, and it's today's society and this idea that society is this advocate for do what makes you happy, no matter the cost. And today's society, if you go out into the world in places that don't have a really active church area, they'll tell you, do in what you do in your life for you. Don't worry about anybody else. Do what makes you happy. Do what makes you feel better off. Gives you more money. Puts you in a better situation. Without care for anything else. And oftentimes, sadly, this gets in the way of what Paul tells us in Philippians 2, 1 through 5. So I'm going to read that really quickly. You can read along with me if you would like. So if there's any encouragement in Christ, any comfort from love, any participation in the Spirit, any affection and any sympathy, complete my joy by being of the same mind, having the same love, being in full accord, and of one mind. Do nothing from selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility count others more significant than yourselves. Let each of you look not only to his own interest, but also to the interests of others. Have this mind among yourselves, which is yours in Christ Jesus. Paul is telling the Philippian church and us today to look within ourselves, and he's asking us, if there's any encouragement in Christ, if there's any comfort in love, if there's any participation in the Spirit or any infection or sympathy within your life, complete my joy by being of the same mind, being of the same love, full accord, and of one mind. He's telling us to be unified in purpose. He's telling us to have the love that Christ had. He's telling us to think the same way as Christ did. And that's something awesome that we all need to strive for. But today, the world today will call you. It calls me. I'm only 19 and I've experienced this many times. And I can't vouch for people that are older than me, but I know that they experience it too and probably have much more than I have. But the world today will call you to work for yourself and only for yourself. And like I said, I struggle with that. But God calls us to do something different than that. He calls us to something different. Now, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with enjoying life. I'm not saying that there's anything wrong with making self something better for yourself. What I'm saying is when that enjoyment that you take by making something better for yourself, by making more money, that enjoyment that you get from doing all that, when that becomes selfishness, that's when it becomes a problem for us in our lives when we walk as Christians. And the most powerful part about this scripture, personally to me, is the word humility, and then the verses that come after these five. It talks about Christ and his example, how he stepped down from heaven, how he left everything behind just to take on flesh, to walk as a human, to be able to be tempted as we are. He served us. He fed us. He healed us. He washed our feet. And eventually he died. Even on a cross, which at that time was considered to be a cursed way to die in the old law. Christ gave everything for us. And Paul, in Philippians, at this moment, is calling the church at Philippi and us to be willing to give everything up for each other. That's something that I struggle with doing. That's something that a lot of people struggle with doing. That's a struggle in the world today. But I want you to know that Christ died on a cross for us, gave up everything, simply because he counted us more than himself. So I challenge you. I challenge you to go out into the world and do something for someone. Make someone's life easier. Make someone's bad day better. Make someone's struggles just a little bit easier to bear because you're helping them. Do these things not because we're called to. Do them because you want to. Because it's what Christ would have done. It's what Christ did do. Christ gave up everything. We should be willing to also. So someday, some point this week, even today, please, please, please challenge yourself to help somebody that's in need, even if it takes you out of your way and makes you just a little bit uncomfortable. Because one of the devil's strongest forces is comfort, and it stops us from doing a lot of things. But once we're able to get out of that comfort zone and serve people in ways that they didn't think possible, we really make a difference and we show so many people the face of Christ. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sam, for that devotional. We really are looking forward to the summer together. And I know y'all have some great plans for the youth. Don't forget, Harold still has his devotional on Friday, and Noah will be preaching this Sunday morning, so you're in for a special treat with that. I'm okay. We're just going to give him the reins for a week and let him have at it, and so we're really looking forward to that treat. As far as all you go, please let us know if you need anything. If you know of anyone who needs anything, we're still here for you. We still want to hear from you, and we look forward to seeing you in person. Before we let you go, let me close out with a prayer. Our Father in heaven, we are grateful for the health of this community, for all the health of those workers and everyone who's been around. And Father, we ask you to continue to be with us as we ease back into reopening our area. And Father, though, we ask you to continue to watch over us and bless us, be with our leaders as we make decisions, the leaders of this congregation, the leaders of our community, the state and the nation. And Father, continue to support us. And Father, we are so grateful and that we can come together, even in this format right now, that you've given us the abilities to come together, the resources, the knowledge, and we ask you to continue to strengthen your church through this. Father, we look forward to being back together, but Father, most of all, we focus on your Son. We're grateful for him and his sacrifice and his example. It's in his name we pray. Amen.